1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months down the road, we have done HR Fridays for half a year now. I'm really excited for what it has been doing across the lives of many people. This month, we're looking at the topic of discipline and self-discipline in particular. And what better person to speak about discipline than today's guest? She's passionate about frisbee, passionate about going to the gym. She loves her yoga, and she's also very good at communications. Joining me today is the head of corporate communications at Nick Holdings, Pamela Abonyo. Enjoy.
Okay, Pamela, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
This is HR Fridays. We're very excited to have you here. This month we've been speaking about discipline, and you know, what better person to talk about discipline than you? Anyway, I normally like to start with an icebreaker. So the icebreaker I have for you is, have you been in trouble before? Something that you did? Have you broken the rules?
Oh, growing up I was very, very naughty. Okay. Such a naughty child. So if I go through all the rules and the things that I've broken, things I've done, it would be here all day.
Just give me just one.
And then all my classmates who know me will start texting me about how, like all the stories we've had before. So I think I'll say yes. As a child, I was very naughty.
Yeah.
Yeah. So there are many rules I broke.
And the repercussions were?
Grave.
Yeah.
My parents, especially my mom, was very strict.
Yeah.
Strict. I had a very, compared to my other friends, people would say I had a liberal upbringing, but my mom, my parents were very strict about the rules they had set in the house. So yes.
As parents grow older, does the level of strictness reduce or it increases?
I think they mellow down.
Yeah.
Because ideally, when you're young, you're impressionable.
Yeah.
So as you grow older, your parents will be, will assume or hope that the discipline they've instilled in you all those years will stick. So they kind of mellow down, especially when they see that, oh, you're going in the right direction.
Yeah.
They'll just kind of mellow.
I like that you've said the discipline that they've instilled in you, because that takes me to the next question. This month we've been looking at discipline, particularly self-discipline. So would you say self-discipline is a choice? Or it is something that comes from grooming? Can somebody just wake up and be self-disciplined, or they need a background of this discipline being instilled in them?
I think it goes both ways. As a child, discipline is instilled, it's groomed in you. But as an adult, it's a choice. Because you have people who come from Christian backgrounds and they've been all these Christian beliefs or have been instilled in them, but as adults they choose to be atheists, leaving behind the Christian values and the discipline. But even as an atheist, I have friends who are atheists, even as an atheist, they still have some of those disciplines of Christianity, love, kindness, honesty. Yeah, so it's a choice. Eventually it becomes a choice you make every single day.
Every single day, to be self-disciplined. Just to bring it out clearly, what is your definition of self-discipline? I know you have brought, you've defined it using Christianity and you know, atheism, which is also true.
Because that's what I know. I know Christianity.
Yeah. So
I chose the opposite spectrum of Christianity, of belief in your higher power.
What I'm asking is because some people define self-discipline as something as simple as making my bed every day. That's my idea of self-discipline.
That is discipline. Well, not everyone makes their bed every day.
Yeah. I know a couple of people that make their bed every day. So the topic of self-discipline is wide.
Yes, it is.
In a workplace setting, how exactly is self-discipline correlated to professional and career development?
So, in making choices every day, so your choices might be, I will, today I'm going to work and I'm going to fleece clients of money. That is a form of discipline. Some people will argue. Or to say, I'll work today and I choose to be honest, you may choose to be dishonest. But now the difference between those two types of discipline, because thieves, there's honor among thieves, so there's also a discipline attached to theft.
Yeah.
So the difference between those disciplines is trust. Because for anyone to grow professionally, socially, you have to have an element of trust. Whether do your friends trust you with their property, do your friends trust you with their children, do your friends trust you with their secrets, do your friends trust you with their whatever they have that they think is valuable, do they trust you? So discipline is not something you, it's a choice you make every day. It's a choice that you make that sometimes might not be an easy choice. It might not be a comfortable choice. But when your friends, your office in particular, your boss trusts you, then the opportunities open up. And that allows for growth, that allows you to climb the ladder pretty quickly. It allows you to, say even when you move and start a business, that trust that you build is what will carry your business. Because they say a man is only as good as his word. So you may have all this money, but your word does not count for anything. So it prevents growth in all aspects of your life. Yeah.
Would you say that there's a thin line between being disciplined and being consistent? Yes. Or they go hand in hand?
I think they go hand in hand.
Yeah.
The line is really thin.
Yeah.
I would call it rice paper thin.
Mm-hmm.
It's really thin.
Yeah.
Because in order to be disciplined, you have to keep doing the same thing over and over again. But when you do it over and over again, it builds.
Yeah.
There's a saying that they say hard work or discipline trumps talent. So you might be a very talented musician, but you don't work towards it. You don't consistently insert yourself in that area of your life that maybe you want to pursue a professional music career. But if musician who is average doesn't really have that talent but puts in effort every single day. The greatest musicians of our time are not the most brilliant. Einstein was not considered one of the most brilliant men until it took him, if you read his biography, constant educating yourself, constant learning, constant pushing the boundaries. And that's why he's one of the most, that's why you always talk about you're not as bright. Not Einstein, it's even a saying.
It's a saying, yeah. Oh, you're as bright as Einstein.
Yeah.
Oh, my child is an Einstein.
Yeah, but the guys who failed in life.
Yeah.
If you look at the guy who owns, I think it's Alibaba. Mm-hmm. Alibaba. The shopping site.
Mm-hmm.
So many people turned him down for job in McDonald's, mm-hmm. but he is one of the most richest men in the world,
yeah.
And his website is. It makes more money than Amazon and God knows eBay combined annually.
Yeah,
so
those are really, really big online.
So you see people like Jack Ma, if you read about them, it's about this thing to get up every morning, even when things are not going well. The discipline to get up when your business is failing and look and say, what can I do better? Another thing about discipline, it's an area that people really don't. Discipline is not sticking to your guns, it's about doing things, but also looking at yourself and saying, how can I be better? And that's what makes the difference between successful people and people who are not successful. Those who actually look at themselves, say, how can I do better? And those who take it as a principle to listen to what other people have to say. So people who have already walked that path, or people who know their path.
Very interesting insights there. I'm just wondering, when you talk about successful people who are successful, would you say that once you master self-discipline, all the other small spheres of discipline come into play, whether it's the financial sphere or financial sphere?
Absolutely.
Religious discipline.
Absolutely.
What is
with discipline comes being comfortable who you are. You've always seen this study that the middle class is that they're spending more than they earn. Because if you are disciplined and you, I'll go back and say, you can only be disciplined if you have a power. Self-discipline can only be achieved if you have a purpose. And one question I always ask people around is, what is your purpose? What do you want to be? So
people, when you define your purpose, then you just walk backwards and start saying, okay, these are the steps I need to take in order to achieve that goal. So if it's, you want to be the most successful entrepreneur in Uganda, you say, okay, that's my goal, that's my purpose, and then you walk backwards and say,
now in order to do this, I need to save. So what do? You cut out all the other expenses. You, if you, for example, drove an expensive car that's hard to maintain, you sell it off and then you downgrade because you need the money to invest.
Yeah.
So all these aspects in life, once you master self-discipline, it just makes all the other areas of your life so much easier. Society tells, and also one thing with discipline, it actually teaches you to realize that what is right. Coming from a Christian background, we have been given commandments by God. And with that, you know what's right and what's wrong. And there's no need for you to be something else. When society tells you, no, it's just a kickback or a couple million, you won't be missed. But as a Christian, you know it's wrong.
Yeah.
It might not get you rich
fast.
As fast,
yeah.
But everyone knows that in order to be sustainable wealth is God.
Yeah.
Steadily but surely, because then you'll understand the true value of money.
Yeah.
Some people say they'll understand the value of money even if it comes in your life. But it's just that discipline of knowing that you know your path, you know your goals,
yeah.
and you're not willing to take unnecessary shortcuts, but actually walk the journey.
So the more disciplined you are, the more your values keep getting strengthened and strengthened and strengthened. See, Pamela, when I was in primary, the teachers used to tell us that discipline is doing the right thing at the right time, in the right place, and with the right people.
Yeah.
So we had to recite it on assembly and whatnot. So not so much to delve into your personal life, but I just want to know, walk me through your day. Like, normal day, are you a routine kind of person? Are you, this is at 8, this is at 9, I'm going to do that at 10? Yeah.
Well, I'm pretty, I'm one of those people who each day is not the same. So I usually, depending on what I'm doing that day, for example, today I woke up, I like to work out, so I did a bit of yoga, because I know, I do go to yoga class, but there are some moves that I'm not conversant with. So I spend the morning
practicing
so that when you go to class,
yeah.
it's a walk in the park.
Yeah.
I also spend time to pray and then get ready. I like waking up early so that I can visualize my day and say, this is what I want to do today. So by the time I get to work, I already know my day has already been visualized. And also, it's I usually spend the morning, a bit of the time in the morning to catch up with my family. I also spend that time in the morning just to say if they slept well, and then I need to go to work. But by the time I go to work, I've already visualized my day. If I have meetings, if I have emails to respond to, what projects are pending, and I have timelines on when those projects should be done.
Yeah.
So that the day is very different. It's also depending if I have a workout class or if I have friends to see that day. They've already been scheduled in the morning. So that's
really you have a plan. You don't
have a plan. Sometimes I like to be flexible, especially if discipline is also one of the key things. Especially if my friends want to meet up and haven't seen each other in a while, I will try to schedule them on top of my already scheduled day. So I'll find a slot for them in my day.
You said you go to the gym, you do yoga. There is a saying that some of the most disciplined people are sportsmen and sportswomen, because sports does something to games. You know, they instill that discipline. You know, you have to be training at this time, you have to wake up at this time, you have to do this number of push-ups. Leads me to my next question. What are some of the tips that someone can be intentional about to adopt self-discipline? Why do I ask? You might find a little girl or a little boy, or even myself, I probably don't know my purpose yet in life, but I want to be successful, and everybody is saying, to be successful, you have to be disciplined. So I'm asking, okay, how do I be disciplined? What do I enroll in to learn discipline? So just give me a few tips on how someone can instill or learn self-discipline.
Again, I want to clarify that I didn't play sport until my mid-20s, so I'm a something I picked up later in life.
Yeah.
But one of the things I realized is saying goes, show me your friends, show me your circle, and I'll tell you who you are. It's actually very true.
Yeah.
Who you interact with, do they inspire you? See, purpose might not be long term. It might be, what is your goal for this year?
Yeah.
What's your goal for today? My goal for today is to say run 10 kilometers.
Yeah.
And then what do? You have to find friends who...
10 kilometers has never been my goal.
Yeah, I'm just saying, like, yeah, you find people who run 10 kilometers and then you find a way of pushing yourself to that 10 kilometers. So that's one of the things. Find purpose in that season. I call it season. Find a purpose in that season and then find a support team that can help you find that purpose in that season. Because if you're, say, 21, 22 and you're getting out of university, and then you find a group of friends whose idea of who are not ready to get jobs, they just want to party and spend their parents' money, and for you have bigger ambitions, then I would recommend you find a different set of friends. Because I mean, the Bible says some friends are here for a season.
Yeah.
So find friends who will help. Find a mentor.
Yeah.
I was lucky to have a mentor at a young age. So find someone who you look up to. That also helps you get some form of discipline in your life.
Mm-hmm.
And again, discipline is not in one day, it's not one night. It is like consistent, years of consistent decision making.
Yeah.
Secondly, read.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the third, read. There's so much literature out there with the internet, which is not taxed. OTT doesn't apply to browsers.
Yeah.
So just read. There are free online books you can download about the areas that you want to be in. And a lot of the people who have been successful, they'll tell you they had to wake up every morning at 4 a.m. and do. I was talking to a friend last week who has so many things going on in his life, and they are all successful. And then I asked him, what do you do? He's like, I wake up at 4 a.m. every single day. Yeah, he has like three jobs. He has a full-time job, three jobs, he volunteers, he's a lecturer. So he says, I wake up every day at 4 a.m. to ensure that my day, that all the things I have to do in the 24 hours. So I asked a friend how he is super, how he gets all his things done.
Yeah.
And he wakes up at 4 a.m. And starts his day at 4 a.m., which probably ends, I don't know, midnight.
Yeah.
So to be able to be disciplined, I'm not that disciplined to wake up at 4 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a lot of discipline and consistency.
Yeah.
Your body needs 21 days to get used to something, to get used to a pattern of life.
Yeah.
So all you, in order to become disciplined, you only need 21 days, which is 3 weeks.
True. I think also one of the things that I like to add is to instill self-discipline, normally start with the little things.
Yes.
For instance, I recently acquired plants. You know, I don't like, I'm not a fan of plants or anything, but just to get the discipline to say, I have to water this plant in the morning and in the evening. In the morning and in the evening. So if you can acquire discipline in that area, tomorrow if I say I have to save 2,000 per day, it will be easier.
It will be easier.
Yeah.
Because you start discipline, and in 21 days, it will be part of you. You wake up every morning and you won't even know any different.
Yeah.
It becomes part of you.
Yeah.
So every journey begins with small steps.
Yeah.
So if you say, I'm going to be saving 2,000 a day, like you say, yes, it's very possible. Every day you put aside 2,000. And it's the thing with attaining those levels of discipline, it's not going to be easy. It won't be rainbows and unicorns.
Yeah.
It will be very hard.
Yeah.
In fact, right before the 21 days hit, your hardest days will be 18, 19, 20 before you hit that. Those will be the toughest. The first couple of weeks, days will be easy, but as you go on, it will be very easy.
Yeah, and you start asking yourself, do I really need plants? Like, why do I have plants?
And sometimes you don't really. Some people say, oh, I did this for a long time and I didn't see results, so I stopped.
Yeah.
And the question is, there's this popular meme, I think, that they share on online, where there's a guy who's digging for diamonds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've seen that.
And then one, he's so close, and then he walks it away. Yeah. But the person above him just keeps digging and hits the diamonds. Yeah. It's the same thing with this place.
Yeah.
Sometimes the gains are not huge, but I would recommend celebrating the small things.
Yeah.
Especially if you're growing, as from my personal experience, in growing in my leadership role, in my managerial role, it has not been a walk in the park. It has been full of so many challenges. Things that I wish I had known 5 years ago to help my career move faster. But then I would not have learned. I would not have learned how to be a team leader, how to handle finances in your department, how to expand your department. And one thing I did is I purpose to learn. I purpose to talk to friends. I've gone back to school many times in order to learn things that I did not know. So it's just about, it's a journey, and that journey begins with one step. You just keep moving forward, one leg in front of the other, and I'm sure this will come second much.
Wow, Pamela, you've given me a lot, but conclusively, I just need you, maybe in 30 seconds, give me your 2 cents on discipline. You can choose any factor of discipline, could be self, financial, or professional, whatever. So just give me your 2 cents on discipline. 30 seconds.
So a friend asked me on Facebook, how can I eat my money also?
Yeah.
This person earns so much money, but is in debt.
Yeah.
So then I took him around and said, okay, this I went through his budget to help him
figure
out his finances. So I went through his budget and I found out that there were so many leakages in his spending. So we went and I even gave him like an entertainment allowance just to make it easier for him. And honestly, the number of times he has fallen are many.
Yeah.
But the one thing I've always told him, and the one thing I've always told him, that whenever you fall, you dust yourself off
and get back.
You get back on it. Yeah. And that's how these things are changed.
Yeah. Wow, 30 seconds. Well done. Thank you very much, Pamela.
Thank you.
You've given me so much to think about personally. I need to go back and first of all Google Alibaba and maybe buy a few things on there. But I do appreciate your time. Thank you very
so
much. To the rest of the viewers, see you next week. And remember, you're the CEO of you.